Moses, how I can raise up ordinary men, turning them to become supernatural beings, financial apostles, making life better, bringing people from the dungeon of sin, bringing them into the faith, planting their feet, and rising them.
The general is in the land. Hallelujah. Fasten your seat belts. Shall we make some noise in the house as we will come? Papa Joshua Igila, all the way from Abuja, Nigeria. Come on, somebody, make some noise. Make some noise. Papa, you are welcome. You are welcome. Hallelujah. Come on, wave your hands. Wave your hands to Papa. We love you, Papa. Ayaya.
Thank you. Are you clamping for Jesus and not for man? Clamp your hands and let the devil know you are clamping for Jesus. Hebrew chapter 11 verse 6. If you are there, you can read chorously with me. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that must cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is the rewarder of them that diligently seek him. For without faith, it is impossible to please God. He that must first come must first believe that God is the rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Today I want to share with us on what I titled Faith to Fulfill Destiny. Faith to Fulfill Destiny. You are a child of destiny. You are not a destitute. You were not created by mistake. You are not a product of a man and a woman that cannot control their biological instinct. God has a purpose. That is why you are here. Hear this. There are some children that are supposed to come to this world. 3 months in the womb of their mother, there is a miscarriage, and that is the end. There are some children that, when they even come to the world, on the day of their delivery, the child dies and the mother dies. But look, because you are still alive now, you are a child of destiny. Hear this. The devil could not stop you the first month in the belly of your mother, the second month in the belly of your mother, the third month in the belly of your mother, the fourth month you were still kicking, the fifth month you were alive, the sixth month you were breathing, the seventh month you were developing, the eighth month you were matured, the 9th month you came out. That's why I know you will fulfill destiny. Jeremiah 29 verse 11, he said, for I know the thought that I think towards you, the thought of peace and of holiness, even to give you an expected end. Am I talking to somebody here? Whatever you desire that you want to become, you are going to be. You will be what God says you will be. Listen to me. If you are a child of destiny, what men say about you cannot stand. It is what God says. Who said you are not going to make it? Who said you will not make it? I'm looking for that person. Who said you will not marry? I'm looking for that person. Who said your ministry will not grow? I'm looking for that person. Who said you will not overtake? I'm looking for that person. When God say yes, no man can say no. Am I talking to somebody here? If you believe that, lift up your leg and shout fire. Hey! 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 The Bible says, whose report shall we believe? We shall believe the report of the Lord. I am what God say I am. I am what God say I am. Gossipers can call you any name, but you are what God say you are. Whatever they say cannot stand. They say you will not make it. That is the lie of the devil. They say you will not give birth. That is the lie of the devil. They say you will not be healed of HIV. That is the lie of the devil. They said your ministry will collapse. That is the lie of the devil. They said you will not build your house. That is the lie of the devil. They said you will not travel abroad. That is the lie of the devil. They said you will not get that position. That is the lie of the devil. They said you are not going to get that job. That is the lie of the devil. When God say yes, no man can say no. When he lifts you up, no man can bring you down. When he takes you up, no power can bring you down. Somebody shout fire. Hear this. Faith is more than confession. Faith is an action. Now hear this. That's why the Bible says faith without work is dead. So you must understand faith is the active part. The active part. Jesus speaking in his word, he said, when the Son of Man return, will he find faith on earth? So you must understand that faith is one of the things that makes us actively circulate around the circumference of life actively. Am I talking to somebody here? Hear this. Faith is a spiritual SIM card of a believer. You did not hear me. Your handset is useless without a SIM card. When faith is inserted into your system, my God, your network is activated. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? What is faith? Faith is total confidence in God. What is faith? Faith is believing God plus action. What is faith? Faith is the substance of things hoped for and evidence of things not seen. For without faith, it is impossible to please God. For him that must first come, must first believe that God is the rewarder of them that diligently seek him. You cannot serve God without faith. You cannot pray without faith. You cannot preach without faith. You cannot receive without faith. You must understand, faith is what makes us believers. So you must have faith. If you are here, you are blind. If you have faith, you can see. Wherever you are, hearing the sound of my voice, you must have faith. The greatest set of people that don't believe are believers. You can have a big Bible and claim to be Christian, and yet you don't believe. When we see miracle, we doubt. We pastors don't even trust one another. We don't trust one another. I have said it. A pastor without power should close his church and start a supermarket. You did not hear me well. A pastor without power should close his church and start a supermarket. The kingdom of God is not in words. It is in the demonstration of the power of God. Somebody shout fire. Shout fire. Shout fire. I talking to somebody here? Facts about faith. Number one, without faith, it is impossible to please God. And that's what we saw in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. You can't please God. The only thing that pleases God is faith. You can kneel down and roll before God. But if you don't have faith in that worship, it's useless. What pleases God is faith. This is the reason. A man of God without faith will become an empty cymbal. Nowadays, we don't have messengers of God. We have commentators on the altar. You know football commentators. They will comment about all the footballer positively and negatively, but they cannot play like them. There are people watching. There are people who came to this crusade. All you came to do, will it work? Is it going to be successful? These are commentators, spectators. And there are people that came to receive. Those of you that came to receive, receive it. Can I talk to you here? There is no man of God that holds monopoly of the anointing. One man of God can pocket God to his pocket. Am I talking to somebody here? Life is turn by turn. When your time comes, you will shine. Shine your shine, I shine my shine. Can I prophesy here? After this crusade, your enemies will die of hypertension. Somebody shot fire. Shot fire. Because of what God is going to do for you, they will not be able to close their mouth. They will not be able to close their eyes. They will not be able to sit down. Their blood pressure will go up. Because with men, things are impossible. But with God, all things are possible. Including HIV. Including Ebola virus. Including cancer. All things are possible. Including your husband. Including having children. All things are possible. Including growing your ministry. All things are possible. Can I talk to somebody here? Number two, saved by faith through the grace of God. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 will help you there. Number three, fact about faith. When I say, let me talk about number two. We are saved by faith. And what does that mean? Through the grace of God. Hear this. You can receive miracle and not have Jesus and go to hell. You can receive deliverance without Jesus, you will go to hell. You must understand that you don't need to know the miracle alone, but you need to know the miracle worker. Hear this. Miracle is the children's bread. You can receive miracle, which is the children's bread. But the greatest is to receive the one who provided the miracle. Can I say this? Jesus is coming back again. He's coming back again. He's coming back. He's coming back to judge the church. Judgment will begin in the household of God. The greatest havoc is that men of God, we preach too much of our church than Jesus. We are not sent to preach our church. We are sent to preach Jesus. On the last day, you will not be asked the name of your church, the name of your pastor. You will be asked, are you washed by the blood of the Lamb? Are you set free by the blood of Jesus? And that's why I came to preach Jesus and not church. If you are not born again, what is the excess of receiving miracle without knowing Jesus? If you are not born again, what is the excess of receiving deliverance without Jesus? If there is any reason for this crusade, it is all about your soul. 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 I'm coming there very soon. Number three, facts about faith. We walk and live by faith and not by sight. Men of faith don't move by sight. They are moved by faith. And what do I mean? When you operate faith, you don't need to see before you believe. I don't need to see before I believe. I am born from an Islamic family. My great-grandfather was a conk Islam, an imam. My father was a conk Muslim. In fact, I became the first Christian in the history of my family. Can I talk here? For 3.5 years, my father placed curse on me because I gave my life to Christ. I couldn't set my eyes on him. He chased me out. I'm going somewhere with this story. I had a pastor that I was looking up to. The night my father chased me out of the house, at about 12 in the middle of the night, I ran down to this pastor for help because I had no place to lay my head. And I want you to get this. I did not know much about the Bible at that time. And I knocked at the door in the middle of the night. And I said, "Sir, I don't have any place to lay my head. Help me, sir." And he opened the door and smiled and said, "I can't allow you in." And I said, "Papa, you know you are the one that is growing me in faith. I don't know where to go." He said, "You can't enter here." I became disappointed because a pastor that I was looking up to as a new convert from an Islamic background closed the door. When I left him, I was depressed. And I told myself, if this is all they do in Christianity, there is no need for me to give my life to Christ. And the Holy Ghost ministered to me. He said, "Son, this journey is a personal race. This journey is a personal race." Right from that day, I discovered that the faith of your pastor cannot set you free. Look, can I talk to somebody here? There are pastors that smoke. There are pastors that drink. If you build your faith on a pastor, you can be frustrated. Your faith should be on the solid rock, which is Jesus. He's the same today, yesterday, and forever. Men can disappoint you, but Jesus will not. We move by faith and not by sight. If you are on a wheelchair, if you are with crutches, forget about the pain. Forget about the difficulty. Remove your eyes from the wheelchair, from the crutches. Place your eyes on the solid rock, which is Jesus, that died. And look at the capacity and the ability that he has. And as I'm preaching, your faith will spring you from that chair. Am I talking to somebody here? The topic is faith to fulfill destiny. Do you know that when men close the door, God can open the door? Am I talking to somebody here? Your faith will produce result. I say your faith will produce result. Whatever the enemy has done against you from today, it's going to be over. I thought you are shouting the amen where? Whatever we do outside faith, it is described in the Bible as sin. In Romans 14 verse 23 downward, you get what I'm saying. So you must understand that there are dimensions of faith. Number one, you have faith in God. Faith in God. Faith in God. Faith in the finished work of God on the cross. Number two, you have faith in the messengers that God have sent. Hear this. Believe the Lord God, thou shalt be established. Believe his prophet, thou shalt prosper. So you must understand that God will not come down to perform miracles. He will use his messengers. And that's why you must have the faith in the messengers that God has sent. The greatest havoc that I've seen in the body of Christ is for people to judge a man without knowing the man. And that's what we do among preachers. Somebody does come and said something, but you did not know, and you concluded. Our faith in the messengers. There are genuine men of God that have been termed fake. And there are fake men of God that have been celebrated all over. On the last day, there will be great disappointment. That man clamp hand for a man of God does not make him genuine. Men can say Hosanna and God does not know you. And that's why in the dimension of faith, you must have faith in his messengers. Number three, you must have faith in his promises. Has he not said it? Will he not do it? Whatever God said, he's capable of doing. Whatever God said, he's capable of doing. If God said, I will lift you up, no bastard can stop it. Whatever God said, he will do. If God has said, I will give you a baby, it doesn't matter how long it has taken. In this crusade, your time has come. You must have faith. Number four, in your future. And what do I mean by faith for your future? When I'm talking about faith for your future, every one of us here has a future. Don't allow any man to judge you by what you are now. You are greater 1,000 times in your inside than what you are now. The devil is not fighting you for who you are now. He's fighting you because of your tomorrow. Now hear this. There are some of you staying in a one-room apartment, but people are jealous of you. Why are they jealous of you? They are not jealous of the one room. They are jealous of your future. You are working in the office as a civil servant. But your boss and people that are around you, they are afraid of you each time they see you. And they backbite you. It is not about your position. It is about what you are going to become in that organization. Are you a politician? And everybody is talking evil about you. They are taking various kind of rumor about you. Do you know why? It is not all about that position. It is about your next level. Your next level. Your next level. Your next level. Hear this. The devil will not fight anything that belongs to him. The greater the opposition, the higher your position. Can I talk to you? You are too loaded to fail. You are too surrounded that you cannot be stranded. You are too anointed to be tormented. I turn your sweat to sweetness. Hi, ya, 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 ya.
Where men are saying there is a casting down, you shall be shouting that there is a lifting up. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to somebody here? I am seeing your future. There is a tomorrow for you. There is a brighter day for you. You dear, there is a brighter day. I am seeing you moving from glory to glory, from height to height. Isaiah 60 verse 1, he said, arise and shine, for the light has come. Am I talking to somebody here? Isaiah 43 verse 2, he said, when you pass through the water, I shall be with you. When you pass through the fire, you shall not be burned, neither shall the flame scorch you. Isaiah 61 verse 1, he said, for the Spirit of the Lord God has anointed me to proclaim liberty to the captive. Isaiah 62 verse 1, he said, for the sake of Zion, I shall not hold my peace. For the sake of Jerusalem, I shall not rest, not until our righteousness went forth like a burning candle. In Psalm 2 verse 1, he said, how do the hidden rage and the people imagine a vain thing, and the kings and the rulers to counsel against the Lord and his anointed. He said, he that seated in the heaven shall laugh at them and have them in derision. He said, some trust in chariot, some trust in horses, but we remember the name of the Lord our God. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower, that when the righteous run in, therein they are saved. The Bible says in Psalm 23, it said, the Lord is my shepherd, for I shall not want. That he maketh me to lie down in greener pasture, yea, he leadeth me beside the still water. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for his rod and staff, they comfort me. He said, thou preparest a table in the presence of my enemy. Thou anointed my head with the oil of gladness, and my cup shall run over. In Romans chapter 8 verse 1, it said, therefore there is now no condemnation for them that are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh but after the Spirit. In Philippians chapter 2 verse 10, it said, wherefore God has given him a name that is highly exalted above every other name, that at the mentioning of the name of Jesus, that every knee shall bow. In John chapter 14 verse 1, he said, let not your heart be troubled, ye believe in God, also believe in me. In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have not told you that I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am, there ye may be also. And Thomas said, Lord, how can we know the way? And Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to the Father except through me. In John chapter 1 verse 12, he said, as many that believeth in him, to them he gave the power to become the sons of God. The Bible make me to understand in the word of God that when he say yes, no man can say no. According to the word of the Lord in Ephesians chapter 6 verse 9 to 12, he said, finally my brethren, put up the whole armor, that you may be able to quench the wiles of the enemy. He said, ye wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against dominions and authority. Today I came with the armor of the Lord. There shall be a change. 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 That devil can't stop you. They cannot hinder you. They cannot stop you. In Psalm 1, he said, blessed is the man that standeth in the way, that standeth not in the ways of the sinner, not seated in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law, and in the law does he meditate day and night. Then he shall be like a tree planted by the waterside. Can I talk to somebody here? In the book of Joshua chapter 5 verse 9, he said, see this day will I remove the reproach of the Egyptians of thy shoulder. In the book of Isaiah chapter 3 verse 10, he said, say unto the righteous, it shall be well. It is well with me in the morning. It is well with you in the afternoon. It is well with you in the night. You shall not die. You cannot die. They cannot stop you. That devil is a bastard. They can't stop you. I see a new business. I see a new job. I see a new job. I see a new job. The Bible says, they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. They shall mount up with wings like eagle. Are you there tonight? Somebody shout fire. Make some crazy noise. Shout fire. Yeah, 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 yeah. Shout fire. Can I prophesy here? Somebody is entering into a position that nobody can take away. If you are there, lift up your leg and shout fire. Hi, yeah, 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 yeah. Hey! Hey! Hi, yeah, 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 yeah. Hey! Somebody shout fire! Shout fire! Shout fire! Shout fire, yeah, 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 yeah. Shout fire! Shout fire! Shout fire! Shout fire! Shout fire! Shut fire, yeah, 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 yeah. Shut fire. Shut fire. Shut fire. Shut fire, yeah, 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 yeah. Shut fire. Shut fire. Shut fire. Shut fire, yeah, 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 yeah. Shut fire. Shut fire, yeah, 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 yeah. Shut fire. Lift up your leg and shut fire. Yeah. Yeah. Tell your neighbor, you are a miracle. Say it well. You are a miracle. Shout it. Let your neighbor hear. Some of you, after this crusade, Makaba, you are about to count money you have never touched in your life. If you are not a winner, say that amen. Where? I am seeing some pastors' ministry exploding here. There's an explosion for ministry here. Haba, Kaba, Koba, Shada, Eko, Bara, Shade, Kolia, Egaba, Rako, Shada, Egaba, Ligaba, Kaba, Kuda, Egaba, Rego, Shada, Egaba, Yagado, Eladu, Saka, Egabaya, Egaduka, Egada, Yada, Rago, Shada, Legaba, Yagada, Ekaba, Yagada, Leba, Shada, Embra, Eko, Shada, Legada, Shadaba, Idaladada, Barada, Shalada, Elatosia, Ebasata, Egaba, Yada, Egabarata, Legusia, Ego sade kole brada, ega basata. Somebody shot fire. Am I talking to somebody here? If you have never experienced a miracle, where somebody that used to love you before begin to hate you, it has not started. There are some friends that cannot stand your lifting. There are people that want you to be serving them. But when God lifts you up, they become jealous and they run away. God is speaking to me. 250 of you here. God wants to separate you from wrong friends. Am I talking to somebody here? Do you know who you are? You can be the next minister, the next governor, the next senator, the next president. You don't believe that? Ask those who are president. They never thought they are going to be president. It happened just that way. Am I talking to great people here? If you don't believe in yourself, I believe in you. Did you hear what I'm saying? If you don't believe in yourself, Brother Joshua Ikila say, I believe in you. Look look here. You are not an afterthought. You are not just a nobody. You are a somebody. 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 You are a star. 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 I say you are a star. You are the next star of your family. You are the Joseph of your family. You are the David of your family. You are the Solomon of your family. You are the Joseph of your family. You are the David of your family. They cannot kill you. They will not kill you. That devil is a bastard. They cannot stop you. They will not kill you. You are a star. You are a star. You are a star. You are a star. You will shine your shine. You will shine your shine. You will shine your shine. I prophesy. You will shine your shine. Somebody shot fire. Hey! Shut fire! Yeah! Shut fire! Shut fire! Shut fire! Yeah! Hey! 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 Shut fire! Yeah! Are you ready?
My God. My God. There are 6 million angels here. They are all over everywhere. My God. Look at angels all over the whole place. My God. My God. Destiny repairers. Destiny repairers. They are here. They are here. Those who look down on you, you are about to surprise them. Did you hear what I've just said now? Nobody has ever made it in your family. Congratulations, you have come to change it. Am I talking to somebody here? Can I say this? Heko Vazia. Zambia. It is now your time. When I was praying to come to Zambia, I saw 3 powerful locations in this country where oil will be extracted. I'm not exciting you. I don't know how. But God said to me, this is a land of mineral resources. But the eyes of the people are closed to see something is about to happen in this country. Can I say this? God said to me, there are 6 generals he wants to rise up in Zambia. I'm not talking about foreigners, foreign pastors coming to Zambia. No. I'm talking about Zambian pastors rising up to become generals. Did you hear what I am saying? Oh, you did not hear me well. What you are running to Nigeria for, you are going to start saying it in Zambia. You did not hear me. Shata, ya. Shata, ya. Shata, 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 ya. It will take a man of God with a genuine spirit to deliver this prophecy. Did you hear what I'm saying? What you are running to Nigeria for, running to other country for, congratulations, is now in your midst. I am not talking about foreigners. I am talking about Zambian pastors rising up to shine. Zambia, I know your time of independence has come. But hear me, it is now a new year, a new time. Your 50th year independence, it is a time to shine. It is a time to shine. Are you hearing what I'm saying? If you believe in your country, shut fire. Can I talk here? Some people in the government who are, can I talk? Can I talk? Can I talk? There are some people with a bad heart who don't know how to celebrate leaders. Who don't know that for somebody to be a president is God that made it so. Nobody becomes a president by mistake. It is God that made it so. Am I communicating? Am I communicating? And what they wish to your president will happen to them. Hear this. There are two people. One in the government and one like an opposition. The sword of judgment is on them because I looked at your president, I saw long life. Now, what they thought is going to happen to him is going to happen to them. Two of them. The sword of judgment is upon them. You might not like the prophecy, but that's what God said I should say. If you are not a witch, say amen to that. Because I'm looking at some people preparing that. Let us see whether this person will go. And instead of this person to go, more life is added to the person. Then more life is not just only added to the person. The people that desire that this person should die are not dying before the person. Hey! Hey! Can I prophesy? Your enemies will die your death. If you don't say that amen, I will suspect you. Your enemies will die your dead. I said they will die your dead. Anyone that wants you to die, they will die your dead. No more tears. No more fears. Shout it again. No more fears. Shout it again. No more fears. Shout it for the last time. No more tears in your family. No more tears in your ministry. No more tears in Zambia. No more tears in your work. No more tears in your finance. No more tears in your destiny. No more tears in your future. No more tears concerning marriage. No more tears concerning your health. That medical report is over. No more. Fears. No more fears. No more fears.